Welcome once again to the impressive Park & Suites Arena, where Montpellier is playing host to 6 days of superb rhythmic gymnastics. It's day five and we await performances in the group all-round competition. The best six qualify for London 2012 as a right, so it's not only medals at stake. 24 groups, Italy the reigning champions, Russia and Belarus the main challengers. On last world championship form anyway, but 12 months can make an awful lot of difference. Bulgaria, Japan, Germany, all in the mix, as are Israel, France and Switzerland. A great competition in store. There's Italy. Gonna work fairly low down the order.
The next group comes from Russia.
And it's Russia we see first. Working with 3 plus 2, it's 3 ribbons and 2 hoops. And up until 2008, they really were in a purple patch. They dominated the sport. Since then, they've been rebuilding. Last year, they were third in the all-around championships. But they were champions with this apparatus, 3 plus 2. And just multiply all of the qualities of rhythmic gymnastics times 5. And 5 of them have to work together, matching and or contrasting shapes, positions, lots of throws and exchanges in store. Accuracy in a limited space for 5 gymnasts is so important. Synchronization inside scale. Some very neat exchanges. And all of these gymnasts have separate roles to perform, and the idea is to gel together into a complete performance. Lovely roll into a safe catch. Every one of the 5 gymnasts must make contact with the apparatus, crucial. Oh, good exchange, very, very accurate. Yeah, the formations change, new patterns emerging. Big throw, safe catch, and what an opening. This is from Russia. To 2.5 minutes, and that's hard work for the 5 of them. Unison in the pivot, beautifully timed. Wow. Remember, these are the challengers. And what a challenge they're putting down. Very full house here, 7,500 capacity, and they're being treated to some super work. Well, Russia have started incredibly well. The exchanges, the patterns, all accurate, using the gymnast as part of the apparatus. 27.6, a huge score to kick off with. Of course, 2 apparatus have to be presented, and then the total is combined to find our winner. This is Belarus. They opened with 5 balls. They were second last year, behind Italy and ahead of Russia in the all-round competition. But this wasn't their strongest apparatus. In the final for 5 balls, they slipped to 5th. So Belarus chasing 27.6, the score for Russia. Oh, look at that. tableau breaks. And the first of the many patterns you'll see. It's got to be at least six different formations. Synchronization that you're seeing here, that has to figure. Just a tiny bit out there. And it does bear repeating that five gymnasts working in this confined space, all of them with their own job to do. They can't collide, the apparatus mustn't collide. Nice, accurate exchange. Cossack in unison, look at that. Even down to the height of the leaps and jumps, they've got to match. You see one pattern, soon it'll dissolve and change into another. There you go. In it and bouncing. Now that's great synchronization from Belarus. Use of the gymnast, look at that. Varying trajectories of the ball, one low, one high, a little bit overreach there. That's a better exchange. Oh, bouncing. Well, exciting apparatus, five ball, because it's so easy to lose control. Walk over to catch, and they go their separate ways to make a new pattern. Nice illusion, and cannon, again a nice little touch from the gymnast. Well, Belarus, that's a strong challenge. A couple of missed timings, the coaching team are quite happy. 27.6 is the target, and look at that star, very unusual. I said when they started, this was one of their weaker apparatus, but they've certainly proved me wrong there. Some lovely stuff to watch here. So accurate with trapping. Look at this, use of the gymnast. Trying to be original. Oh, they're just off the pace, 27.525. Second at the moment, Belarus with one apparatus. Russia presenting their second of two routines. They're in the lead by 0.075 over Belarus. Another good score would give them the lead. But remember, there's Bulgaria, Italy still to come. Italy, the world champions, of course. So they need a hefty total here. Focus. Opening with some footwork, sliding across the top of the ball. That's in cannon, not always synchronized. Different formations formed in different ways. Still, they have to work together. And they're allowed to show us up to 14 difficulties. And six of those must be exchanges in the apparatus. Oh, that's nice. And six must be exchanges in the apparatus. Lofty exchange and a safe trap, and a new pattern emerges. Dice 5, and that breaks into yet another formation. This time, in Indian file. Matching the height of the throws, very important for the timing, of course. All the gymnasts using and helping each other. Oh, and there's an error. That could be costly. She's back into the swing of things now. All these little touches bouncing off bodies and the floor. There you see an example. One ball making the journey between the two by being bounced. The other's being thrown. Well, they've got back into the rhythm now. Good synchronization in the pivots. There's the Dice 5 formation again. Well, one or two shaky movements and the ball decided to leave a grasp at one stage, and that would be expensive. But their 27.6 to open was very strong. It's not going to be that high this time. It's mesmerizing the way they use the area, travel across it in different ways, make different patterns, and all the time focusing with the apparatus. Fascinating. Use of the gymnast. Now, how costly was that error? 27.25, a little bit down on the 3 plus 2. 54.85, the lead so far. Bulgaria. Those of us with long memories, if we just go back to the mid-90s, they were absolutely supreme. Consecutive world titles. In the Olympic Games in 96, they got a silver medal. They've been there or thereabouts since, but they've yet to relive those halcyon days. Bulgaria, with 3 plus 2. Fifth. They were. Last year. Dramatic. Phantom of the Opera. The choreography and choice of music so important. When you think you've got 6 meters of ribbon there to control, three of them working at the same time. Oh, just a little bit of hesitation underneath and almost missed. That's good. Synchronize. And they've regained some of the harmony. Good, safe exchange. Do too much of a gymnastic type exercise. The apparatus counts, the patterns, the formations. They have to keep the quality, the essential qualities of the gymnastics. Nicely timed in the walkover. Even the lowering of the leg was together. See, sometimes they work contrasting type body skills and but it all blends together quite beautifully. A bit of acrobatics in the middle. Lovely use of the apparatus. Wow, an interesting finish. The world looks better from upside down. Well, that was a good performance. Have they returned to those great days of yesteryear? Good to see Bulgaria producing some fine work once again. Use of the gymnast. Look at this. Always seeking new ideas. That's given them 27.325. They've gone into second position ahead of Belarus, still behind Russia. The world champions, Italy. And not only the reigning world champions from last year, but the year before that. They are very special. Opening with five balls, and it'll give us a chance to compare. I mean, Russia with five balls were 27.25. They're out in front at the moment, so it'll give us a chance to just compare like with like. Now, Italy are renowned for unusual choreography and quite hectic, frantic even, pattern changing. Very, very quick and very accurate. Oh, look at that. That's such a marvelous touch. Ring pivots in time. First of the big exchanges, beautifully done into back walkover, and the scale shown as well from it. Of every body part. Tiny, tiny fraction out there on the catch. But this, really quite mesmerizing to watch. Whoa. Oh, look at the timing. Well, they work together so beautifully. Indian file, it'll change. So accurate into the illusion. There's the dice five, very popular formation. Crowd loving it. Very good turnout of the audience this afternoon. Oh, and just a tiny bit out there, but really, it's a minor fault. I told you it was frantic. So much to do. Cramming into 2.5 minutes, some super work. Italy, well, once again, captivating routine. Forget for the moment the total they're chasing from Russia. Just compare like with like and see if they can match the 27.25 that the Russians scored with this apparatus. That will give you an idea whether they're on course or not. Walk over. Look at that little touch. And ready to get the return ball. 27.35, remember then. They were just a tenth up on Russia. Italy take the floor for their second and final apparatus, knowing exactly what they have to do. They got the better of the Russians with five balls. Now they need 27.5 to tie. Any more than that, and they're world champions for the third time in a row. Not a sign of overreach yet in the exchanges. Perfectly matched exchange with hoops. The big challenge is controlling those runs. Look at this. Very cleverly done. Lovely contrast in music and mood. Again, that intricate use of the apparatus, ribbon around hoop, no tangles, good, clean exchange work. Look at that. Matching spirals, and now we're snakes. And away, come away with William Tell, and they're going away here with this world title. If they keep this up. Super fast exchanges here, as well as the high floating ones. Huge exchange, intricate patterns, using each other. It's all here. Absolutely roaring their approval. Almost there. Boy, oh boy, what a finish. What a routine. The Russians, well, I don't know if they're that pleased watching, but you have to take your hats off. What an amazing performance. Kanaeva, there she is. She knows we're looking at her. Well, it was dramatic, wasn't it? Exciting, lots of action, unusual work, great choreography. Italy. You deserve to be champions. I hope the judges agree. Look at that, so intricate. Oh, there's number six gymnast. Oh, there you go, look at that. 27.8, the high score of the whole competition. 55.15. They are once again world champions. They can't believe it. Three in a row. That is unbelievable. They all want to get on the act. Look at this. Let's celebrate. Well, wonderful moment. Tears take over. Tears of joy. It's fantastic. And the crowd ecstatic. Three in a row. Brilliant. Confirmation then. Italy, world champions once again. Russia takes second. Third, Bulgaria. And the top six places, remember, qualify automatically for the Olympic Games. Spain and Greece down there. They've had tradition in the past. China, down in 16th. They were silver medalists in Beijing. Good performance from Canada to come 17th, to get in the top 24 is something of an achievement in its own. Italy, accept the plaudits, wonderful performance, can take it. The Italians triumphant.